Well, it's amazing to have you here with us. Can you talk to us just a little bit about your character, Billy, and where he falls in breathing life into this true and somewhat appalling story?
Yeah, so my character, Billy, is effectively an amalgamation or a composite of several different real-life representatives for Purdue Pharma. So he is a sales rep, effectively, and he's tasked with introducing OxyContin into predominantly sort of mining communities, rural parts of America where there are kind of a lot of labor-intensive jobs, and people were very, very kind of like liable to get injured and need pain relief. I think initially he goes into the job with sort of good intentions, and there's an element of him being quite benevolent, but he quickly discovers that all is not what it seems. And the reality of this scenario, and this is what the show is largely based on, is that Purdue fraudulently promoted this highly addictive drug as a legitimate form of pain relief when it never should have been on the market. And they encourage salespeople like my character to engage in bribery and deception, and that is something that I can't really escape from, and eventually he becomes kind of embroiled in the culture at Purdue and entrapped by the enticing nature of the money and the status that came with climbing the ranks there.
An enticing cast to be working alongside on this project. Can you talk a little bit about, I guess, particularly people like Michael, and what an amazing learning experience it must be again to be on set with these titans?
Yeah, for me to work with someone like Michael Keaton, to be in the same series as Rosario Dawson, Kaitlyn Dever, who's like my favorite actor on the planet, I think, at the moment, was so exciting. And I just feel like immensely grateful. Anytime I've done panels or, carpets like this with this show, and I've looked at who I'm in the company of, I really, really genuinely can't believe it. Michael specifically is someone who I feel like I learned a lot from just by watching how he conducts himself. And, he's a real, real pro.
Talking about excitement and working with brilliant people, obviously we've had the extraordinary exciting news from James that you're going to be joining not only the Marvel family but more specifically the Guardians gang. What does that mean for you, and how excited are you to be stepping in not just to the Marvel world but specifically the Guardian side of the universe, which we all know is the most fun?
I feel really lucky, man. I'm very honored to be welcomed into the Marvel family. Everyone I've interacted with at the MCU has been amazing, and I think being involved in a franchise like Guardians, which as you say is particularly characterful and very, very creative, is a true honor. So.
Obviously with Adam Warlock, he's a character known to comic fans, perhaps less known to a wider audience. Is that a little bit more liberating than taking on like a Spider-Man or a Superman, where people maybe have very strong expectations? Does it give you more freedom, I guess, to explore things and mix things up with James?
Potentially. I'm just very excited to be involved in any capacity, and I get started in a couple of months, so just focused on preparing now, and I can't wait to get started.
Finally, very quickly, what is it about James's story? Obviously working with Danny on this, and he's a great storyteller. What is it about James that most excited you as a storyteller?
Really, really unique vision. I think he has very much his own kind of tone, and really kind of like carves out his own path as a creative. Just very, very inventive and a real sense of playfulness, and it's what I love about the Guardians franchise, and it's what I love about James. He also seems like a great dude, so I feel very, very lucky to be working with him.
Good luck with the gold spray tan. Thank you for the chat.